Pakistan has had a history of overcoming many adversities, and it's also still a relatively new country. But becoming a country was perhaps one of its biggest adversities to overcome. And Pakistan becoming an independent state is due largely to the efforts of one man, Muhammad Ali Jinnah. So hey guys, thanks for joining me here on another episode of FTD Facts, and I'll be looking at 10 surprising facts about the life of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, who's referred to also as the father of Pakistan. Now this episode will be in chronological order, highlighting the important events of his life. So let's just jump right into it. Starting at number 10, Muhammad Ali Jinnah was born on December 25th, 1867 in Karachi, now in Pakistan, but back then it was part of British India. His father was a very successful Muslim merchant, and by the way, when he was born, his name was Muhammad Ali Jinnah Bhai. He was educated at the Sindh Madrasat ul Islam University and the Christian Mission School. And soon after that, Jinnah joined the Honorable Society of Lincoln's Inn in 1893 in London and became the youngest Indian to be called to the bar 3 years later. Jinnah started out in the legal profession and then he went on to become one of the most successful lawyers in Bombay. Once he had himself firmly established in the legal profession, Jinnah joined politics in the year 1905 using the platform of the Indian National Congress. And again, in 1905, Jinnah went along with Gopal Krishna Gokhale, who was another prominent Indian freedom fighter, as members of Congress to England to negotiate with them about Indian self-government during the British elections. A year later, he served as the secretary of Dadabhai Naroji, who lived from 1825 to 1917, who was also the Indian National Congress president at the time, which was considered to be a great honor for Jinnah. At the Calcutta Congress session in December of 1906, he also made his first political speech in support of the resolution on self-government. In January 1910, Jinnah was elected to the newly constituted Imperial Legislative Council. All throughout his parliamentary career, which spanned 4 decades, he was probably the most powerful voice in the cause of Indian freedom and Indian rights. And it was very evident that ever since Jinnah entered into politics in 1906, he became one of the most prominent voices working for the cause of Hindu-Muslim unity. One of his major achievements happened in the year 1916. Jinnah was responsible for the pact signed between the Indian Congress and the All Indian Muslim League, known as the Congress League Pact of 1916, or more commonly known as the Lucknow Pact. Now, the Lucknow Pact was the only pact that was ever signed between these two organizations, and this was important because these two political parties represented the two major communities in the Indian subcontinent. The pact gave Muslims the rights to their own election process. Also, with these new rights given to them, this meant that the All Indian Muslim League would receive recognition as a representative organization for Muslims, which gave Muslims a greater representation in Indian politics. Now, when violence started to creep into Indian politics, Jinnah became very upset. Jinnah believed in what was called ordered progress, and Mahatma Gandhi's methods of satyagraha, which is civil disobedience, and the government boycott movements became too extreme for Jinnah's methods, and Jinnah got very uncomfortable with that. Jinnah believed that Gandhi's doctrine of non-cooperation actually contributed to increasing resentment and wouldn't achieve anything constructive. Jinnah left Congress soon after the Nagpur Congress session of 1920. The Nagpur Congress session adopted Gandhi's strategies as well as his ideas, and Jinnah just couldn't support that. A lot of distrust between the Hindu and the Muslim communities continued to rise, and because the Hindus failed to meet the demands of the Muslims, Jinnah's efforts came to nothing. For example, the Delhi Muslims' proposals of March 1927 in order to bridge Hindu-Muslim differences on the constitutional plan, the proposal even waived the most basic Muslim demand, which was the right to a separate electorate made by the Lucknow Pact. In fact, Jinnah became so upset with the state of politics in the affairs of the subcontinent that it caused him to migrate and settle to London for a while in the early 1930s. He did, however, return to India in 1934 when people begged him to come back and he assumed leadership of the Muslim community. In 1936, Jinnah rejoined the Muslim League. Now, the situation in India had become extremely discouraging at this time. Provincial parties in Punjab, Bengal, Sindh, the Northwest Frontier, Assam, and Bihar had come up to serve their personal interests. Extremely frustrated with the situation, Jinnah decided to focus his efforts into organizing the Muslims into one platform. He focused all of his energy into turning Muslim India into a powerful force like no other. The Muslim League won 108, which is about 23% of the seats out of a total 485 Muslim seats in various legislature. Even though that this wasn't an impressive number, the fact that the League won the largest number of Muslim seats and that it was the only all-Indian party of the Muslims in the country was a huge boost in their confidence. This put Muslim India on the map of the subcontinent. And finally, the last thing I want to share is when the Congress came to power in July 1937, the Muslims became convinced that in the Congress's scheme of things, Muslims would only be able to live in India as second-class citizens. And Jinnah's efforts gave the Muslim community the will to live and fight on as a nation. And from this was born what would change the face of the Indian subcontinent forever: separate Muslim nationhood and a separate Muslim state, which of course eventually happened due to the influence, the leadership, the determination of Muhammad Ali Jinnah. It gave birth to one of the most powerful nations now on earth, Pakistan. So that's all the facts I have for you about the life of the father of Pakistan, Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Thank you guys so much for watching, and be sure to leave your thoughts and comments down below. I want to hear your thoughts, your input, anything that you got to say. Now, if you stuck around to the end, why not check out another video? I got one right here for you. Just tap the annotation. It'll take you to it. My social media links are also below in the video description section, so you can follow me and see what I'm doing when I'm not here in the studio filming FTD Facts episodes. To join the FTD Facts family, hit that subscribe button and ring that bell, and that way you'll also be notified of our daily episodes. I don't want you to miss any of them.